To be honest, I'm very happy. I'm very happy because the girls are responding really well. The level of the players is pretty good. We have realized and we have seen young talents with a huge potential in the training camp. And also those players that are not that young and they have more experience, they are also very keen to learn and very keen to listen and very keen to put an extra effort to make the things happen. So we are really, really happy with the team right now.
So you mentioned the young players. So obviously this is a young squad that you've called in. How important do you think is that blend or mixture of youth and experience in a squad? And do you think that right mixture is here with us right now?
It's absolutely needed. I think the average of the team should be between 22 and 25, let's say. But obviously we need experienced players who are going to push the young players and they are going to help the young players to follow not the rules, but to get a track in a proper career in football here. And also the young players are bringing freshness and are bringing... They are young and so they are very spontaneous and they are trying things and they are taking risks that is really, really important for them.
So what is the one thing that has surprised you the most about this group of players that you didn't expect?
The hunger that they have for making things happen. They need and they are craving for that step forward for them, for not only women's football, for the football in general in Pakistan, because they are not only talking about women's football, they are talking about football in general. So it's very, very kind for them and it's very nice. That hunger and that craving for making the change, for being part of that change that can happen in the future. So for me, I was expecting that maybe they were going to be more close, they were going to be closer or whatever, but they have been like open from the beginning and they are, we are having every lunch and every dinner, we are having a different discussion how to improve the things and they are giving me their feedback and I'm discussing with them the situation and it's, for me, it's, I'm learning a lot from them and it's very uplifting the response from them.
Fantastic. And what are you most excited about moving forward with the women's national team?
The first target of having the training camp was creating the hype with the women's football, especially because the national team is the top tier of football here in Pakistan. The second thing should be obviously creating a proper system for the players, not only in the women's championship. We need a regular league that is going to be for 4 months. We discussed in the last interview we had. It should be something that should be regular because if not, it has happened here in the training camp that the players have not been having a proper competition since January. So obviously it has been 9 months without competing properly. So obviously we are having some physical issues and we are having some limitations. So the idea is to improve the system, to give them a proper regular training schedule, a proper competition schedule. We are going to try to create a regular league, not only a championship, which is going to be a league. But I think the biggest challenge is to provide the platform for the young girls to start competing and to start developing when they are 13, 14, 15, etc.
So speaking of 2021 specifically, what are your plans for next year for the women's national team itself?
Hopefully the idea is to set up the blueprint or give the foundations of that league that we need to have, that we absolutely need to have. But obviously we have to use the next Women's Championship as a pilot project of something that can improve. And using that Women's Championship, we can set up the foundations about how to develop that league, because obviously the feedback from the Women's Championship is going to be really important for finding the way to develop the Women's League here.
And so for football fans in Pakistan, will these camps and will these the national team activities be more regular under you?
I am very hopeful that it's going to be more regular because not only in the women's, it's going to be only in the men's. We need more activity for the national teams. Unfortunately, with the men's teams, we don't have any competition in front of us apart from the under 23 men's Asian Cup. But in the women's football, we have right now three competitions in front of us. They are the under 17, they are the under 20, and the senior Asian Cups that are a huge challenge. Maybe we are not going to be able yet to compete in a good level, but I think we are going to feel the difference and we are going to feel the change.
And lastly, what is your message to the football lovers of Pakistan who want the women's national team to succeed in the future?
I think the main thing we have to do is to support the girls. They need to feel the support of from the people. They need to feel the support from their families. They need to feel the support from their school. They are going to be able to find a balance between their education and the football career. As well, I think we have to make them, like, I think we have to start creating that hype about Hasrahan. Hasrahan is a role model, but there are more players that are involved in the development of football that maybe they haven't been that famous in the past time, and we have to help them to get promoted because they are also like models, real models, and we have to help them to promote. Plus the young girls, I'm talking too much about the young girls, but I have fell in love with the young girls because they have a huge talent. They have a huge talent, and we have to promote and we have to provide them the platform and the system for that.